我们在座的人大家都知道，所有的现在的很多的幸福的源泉，幸福的来源的话，按照西方心理学的观点来讲，要么是相乐性的幸福的一种这个以相乐性的一种幸福的来源，就是一个。
I think everyone sitting in the audience would probably agree with this, that people would say that there are two sources for happiness. One is from hedonic pleasure.
这个相当于是我刚才所讲到的无根所带来的这种感官上的享乐。
That is similar to what we talked earlier about the five faculty consciousness.
虽然感官它自己不能分别，但是感官的作用跟意识配合以后的话呢，就是它得到啊，我今天很美，看到很美的东西啊，我吃了很好的汤啊，但是这种就是第一次有一种特别好的快感，然后你吃爱汤吃的人第一口吃的时候特别甜美，然后过了最后。 第六课的时候呢，都精彩呀，甚至不好吃，就是甚至有厌烦性。In
fact, this is very much related to what Buddhism is talking about. This sense of hedonic pleasure is connected to our five faculty consciousness. And whenever we see something nice, we taste something sweet or something delicious. Although the five faculty consciousness do not discern, but that information sent to the mind consciousness, that's when the discernment happens. And people could feel a sense of thrill or pleasure when that happens. However, that sense of pleasure will degenerate really quickly. For example, if you really like sweets, the first candy always tastes wonderful. When it goes to the sixth, you just want to vomit.
包括现在很多人沉迷的很多的这种快乐呢，其实跟感官性的幸福有关。Many
people would consider that happiness nowadays is very closely correlated with this sense pleasure.
比如说，你去一个非常美的地方，第一次去看的时候，哇，好幸福，好看呐、啊！然后过了一会儿就没有感觉了。 包括你对感情也是，刚开始的时候，很多人觉得很甜蜜，真的最后自己有拥有的时候呢，也并不是那么的快乐。For
example, when you go to a really beautiful place, when you see the scenery for the first time, you feel really touched and very happy. But after a little while, it just gets really tiring. It is exactly the same for romantic relationships. At the beginning, it's all really beautiful and sweet and romantic, but later on, that lovey-dovey would die soon.
任何我们的跟身体有关的，不管是眼耳鼻舌身的那个，跟身体有关的这些快乐呢，得完了以后呢，就是很快会它的细胞或者说它的一些建筑发生变化的时候呢，就会消失。
At the beginning of this kind of pleasure, this kind of hedonic pleasure or sense pleasure, it's always very refreshing, always nice to have. But later on, after that sense of pleasure happened, it would disappear right away, so it doesn't last long.
还有，幸福的一个来源呢，其实是，应该是，像亚里士多德，他所提倡的，就我们这个生命的意义，就生命意义性的一种快乐。Another
type of happiness is what Aristotle stated in his book. It is the meaning of life or human flourishing, or eudaimonia.
他可能是主要是，比如说一个文学家，或者说是一个研究某一个领域的时候呢。 最后，他的研究得到了社会的认可，体现他的价值的时候呢，他的这种心里面有自然而然产生一种快乐，但这种快乐的延续性呢比较长。Let's
say if there's a writer who wrote his articles and his articles were valuable to society and he achieved success, So he will feel happy, and that sense of happiness will last much longer.
这是刚才我讲的佛教里面呢，就是从意识层面的有一种快乐。意识层面的快乐呢，实际上是使他如果真正明白了这个道理的时候，他所得到的快乐，他所体现的价值呢，对你带来的快乐呢，时间就是比较长。
And this sense of pleasure or happiness is the happiness that's connected to consciousness. And once you realize how this happens, that sense of happiness will last longer.
我们现在社会当中的很多人的需求快乐呢，是比较直接的，就像吃快餐一样的，很快的马上要得到自己快乐，而他希望呢。就是这样的快乐的是永远不要消失。
Nowadays in our society, unfortunately, the happiness that we want to obtain is very direct course. It's kind of like having fast food. You have to have it now. You have to have it fast. However, unfortunately, that will go or dissipate really fast as well.
但需求快乐的过程当中呢很多人的选择呢，我认为是并不是很好。
But in the pursuit of happiness, I feel many made the wrong choice.
现在很多人追求快乐，尤其是通过碎片文化，通过碎片文化来获得快乐。我听到，像美国的话，三分之二的人就是依靠一些媒体的，就是一些短短的这个新闻来充实自己，然后。体现人生的价值观而获得幸福。
Nowadays, there are people trying to obtain happiness through the fragmented information, the short information that we have in our society nowadays. I heard that about 2/3 of Americans fulfill their life with short media clips.
也有一部分人的话，现在是沉迷在一些游戏当中。在虚拟的这样的这个世界当中，整天呢，可能通过有一些不现实的、不真实的游戏，或者说是不真实的信息来充实自己的生活。
And there are some who dwell in video games, who dwell in that virtual reality, that virtual internet reality.And trying to fulfill their life through that means.
很多人在现实当中出现了很多的问题的时候呢，就对此不满，但是呢，自己也不愿意面对，就是一直是有一种逃避的这个心。
And there are some who would like to there, and there are some who chose to run away from difficult situations in real life.
现在人们就是这种叫做是一种病态，叫做是，滥爱患者，就是也就是说，他非常可怕的一种状态。明明是你要面对的，但不敢面对，就是他一直逃避。
And people call and nowadays people call this as a mental illness. It is almost like a cancer of laziness because people always try to avoid.Facing the difficulties using many different ways to delay it, to procrastinate it, and this is considered as a cancer of laziness.
最近我遇到了一些教授，他们也对现在的年轻人比较担忧。
I met some professors, I talked to some professors recently, and they're quite concerned about students nowadays.
他们说现在的年轻人呢，不好好学习。就每天的是除了享受生活以外的话呢，也没有理想，也没有像对家庭负责任，也没有像对社会负责任，整天都是一种浑浑噩噩当中度过。
They said that young people nowadays are very concerning because worth our worry because nowadays they don't study, they only want to enjoy life, they don't have any ideal to pursue, and they don't want to be responsible to their family or the society.
他们认为呢，就好像我们现在的很多人呢，就整天都是在一个浑浑噩噩当中，在一个罪甚蒙事的这么一个 状态当中，没有更崇高的这个理想，就是非常担忧我们人类的未来。
So, people seem to dwell in this state of a blur. There's nothing really happening. There's no higher ideal. Therefore, I'm really concerned about the future of our society.